Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel.
Mr. Excel's here. There's nothing.
Don't fear the spreadsheet podcast, episode number 6. All my numbers are corrupt. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. This podcast is actually one of the features in the book. We have a section called You Did What? And these are true stories sent in by people who watch the podcast of things that they've seen their coworkers do. Tyler, what's the question for today?
Why do all of my numbers keep turning to pound signs? Have I somehow managed to corrupt all of my data?
Hey, Tyler. Okay, yeah. Those pound signs. Now, in the United States, we call these pound signs. I understand in the UK, those are hash signs. Maybe we should just call them number signs. Anytime that you see number signs like this, it means that the column isn't wide enough for the data. And Excel treats things differently. So, if you have some long text and it spills out of the right side of the cell, that's fine. They don't have a problem with that. They'll let it spill. It spills into the next column. And then if you put a number there, well, okay, they figure it's not that bad if you see just some of the text and not all of the text. But with numbers, they absolutely will not do that. If you can't see the whole number, see, they make it wider for you at first. But then if you resize the column and they can't show you the whole number, rather than showing you just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, they change that to the pound sign, number sign, hash sign, whatever you call it. So when you see the pound signs, it means your column is not wide enough. All right, now, how do we make the column wider? Well, one way is to come here between B and C, and you see you get that cursor with the two-headed icon, and you can drag. All right, but frankly, dragging is a real drag because you never know how wide to make it, and you end up, you know, like just way too wide, and then you're, you know, doing this whole little number. So a very cool trick is something called Autofit columns, and a good way to do that, select all of the cells, all of the columns, and then come out here to the right and double click instead of dragging, and it'll make all the columns wide enough for the largest number in the column.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next episode. Check out Don't Fear the Spreadsheet. This book makes Excel for Dummies look like it was written for rocket scientists.